In this example, we need to calculate all internal forces and draw the internal forces diagrams. Even though we are not given specific values for the load at the end of the cantilever beam or its span, we will still be solving as if they were known. The first step is to define the points of interest where we will be performing sections. So we have one point of interest at point A, another one at point B, because that's the left and right end of the beam. There would also be another point of interest where the point load applies. However, it happens that in this case, the load applies directly at point B. So these two points of interest coincide. In other words, we only have two points of interest in this example, which means that it is quite easy to solve. Now, the next step would be to draw the free body diagram. I will draw it over here. So if this is our beam, we do have load W over here. Its span is L. And now, instead of the fixed support, I will just draw a vertical reaction. Let me call it RAY. A horizontal reaction. Let me call it RAX. And the moment, I will call it MA. As you can see over here, I already drew the support reactions in the same direction as the convention, the sign convention we are using for the internal forces. This is quite helpful because I can easily use it to get the internal forces. Here in this example, we will just show that this rule applies, and you can use it as it is when you are working questions on your own. So, to calculate the support reactions, we need to apply the equations of equilibrium. Because we have a fixed support, and of course because it is a cantilever beam, the order in which I will apply the equations of equilibrium will not change the amount of work I need to do over here, because in each equation I can calculate one unknown support reaction. Nevertheless, to have some consistency between examples, let me start with the sum of moments about a point strategically selected. Of course, here I need to take the sum of moments about point A, because RAX and RAY are unknown, so this way these forces will have a zero moment, and of course the only unknown variable in the equation will be the moment at point A. So if I assume that the moments which are clockwise are positive, I always start with the moment MA. Now, I already mentioned that RAX and RAY have a zero distance from point A, so their moment about point A is zero as well. And I only have force W. It tends to rotate beam AB clockwise, so it is a positive moment, plus W times L, as L is the perpendicular distance from A to W. These need to sum up to zero, so if I solve for MA, I can see that this is minus WL. In other words, since it is negative, it implies that MA would be a counterclockwise moment, even though I drew it as clockwise. However, as I already mentioned, it is quite useful because this will be also the internal force at point A. Now let's go to the sum of forces in y direction, which has to be equal to zero. I can see that the unknown variable points upwards, so it is convenient to select the forces that point upwards as positive. And I will start with the unknown variable, which is the support reaction, the vertical support reaction at point A, so Ray, minus W equals zero. So Ray equals W. Last but not least, I have to go to the sum of forces in x direction. Even though we can see here that we only have Rax, so we already know that it will be zero, we need to show that as well. So Rax equals zero. Once again, as you can see, even though it does not make any difference, I selected the direction in which the unknown variable points, so I will not have to change the sign and of course minimize the amount of calculations here. Now that I know the support reactions, I can perform sections at the points of interest, which is a bit right from point A and a bit to the left from point B. So section a bit to the right from A, now this a bit implies that what I will be calculating is practically on point A, but because mathematically it's impossible to define the internal forces on point A, I need to define them in a distance which is next to zero from point A. So let me draw the section. Now, of course, this section is considered to be on the free body diagram. So here I will draw the support reactions that I have already calculated. So here I've got Ray, which is W, and I've got Ma, let me just draw it like that, which is negative WL. On the right side, I will draw the internal forces in the positive sign convention, which is this one. This would be Na, this will be Sa, and this will be Ma. So if I solve for them, I will see that I will just calculate all of them directly. Let me start with the sum of forces in x direction, so that you can see that regardless the equation I select to start with, I will always calculate one variable. It is easy to imagine the section as if it was a cantilever beam. So if the sum of forces in x direction is zero, this means that Na, now here if I had Rax, it would be minus Rax equals zero. So in other words, Na would be equal to Rax. So as you can see, having calculated Rax, I already know Na, which in this case it is zero. Let's go to the sum of forces in y direction, which has to be equal to 0. And I will assume that the ones pointing downwards are positive because SA points downwards. So SA minus W equals 0, or in other words, SA minus RAY equals 0, or if you want, SA equals RAY. So once again, knowing RAY, I know SA as well, which is what I mentioned earlier. SA equals W. Of course, we have to get the sum of moments as well about point A. Point A is over here. The sum of moments about point A has to be equal to 0. I see that the unknown internal force is counterclockwise, and I select this direction as the positive one. So MA, which is counterclockwise, minus the moment over here, which is clockwise, but it is also minus WL, equals 0, or MA plus WL equals 0, or MA equals negative WL. As you will see here, all of the internal forces at point A are exactly equal to the support reactions at point A. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, you don't have to do that yourselves. You can just apply this rule directly. So here you can just say that this is all of these are equal to the internal forces, and that should be all, instead of having to show the working yourselves. And now here I only need to perform a section at point B, a bit left from point B. So let me draw the free body diagram for the section. Now I will keep the right part and substitute the left part with internal forces. So it will look something like that. And the internal forces will look like that. The axial ones are pointing to the left. The shear ones are pointing upwards, and the bending moments are clockwise. S, B, M, B, and N, B. So once again, I just need to apply the equations of equilibrium in any order, and I will calculate the internal forces. So let me do that in the same order I did the previous one. The sum of forces in x direction has to be equal to 0. The ones pointing to the left are the positive ones, so NB equals 0. The sum of forces in y direction has to be equal to 0. The forces pointing upwards are positive, so SB minus W equals 0, or SB equals 0. And the sum of moments about point B has to be equal to 0. The clockwise moments will be the positive ones. So MB equals 0, because all of the forces apply directly at point B, so they have no moment. So here, all I need to do is to construct now the internal forces diagrams. If this is the bending moment diagram, this will be the shear force diagram, and this will be the axial force diagram. Now here, because I have no values for the forces or the spans or anything, there is no need to add any units. After all, I don't know what the units are. So all I need to do is to add what I have already calculated. Now I know that the moment at point A is negative WL, and we have said that when it comes to the moments, we draw the negative ones above the axis and the positive ones below the axis. The axis, of course, is also representing the beam. However, when it comes to shear forces and axial forces, it's the other way around. So here, this is negative WL, and here it is zero. Because I only have point loads, I can connect these points of interest with straight lines. So, assuming that this is a straight line, this will be my bending moment diagram. Similarly for the shears, the shear at point A is W, it's positive. The shear at point B is also W. So once again, since I only have point loads, and this had a rectangular uniformly distributed load, I can connect the points with a straight line. So this is my shear force diagram. For the axial forces, because in both cases it is zero and I don't see any other force or perhaps a uniformly distributed load between these two points, it is safe to assume that it will be zero all over. So this is how I draw a zero internal force diagram. And this will be the answer to this question.